there were two friends, a tortoise and a fish. Okay? The fish lived inside, sometimes jumped out. The tortoise lived inside as well as could come out of the water. Clear? But every time the tortoise wanted to talk to the fish, every time the tortoise wanted to talk to the fish, when the tortoise was outside water, the fish did not respond. Clear? So when the tortoise was inside water, the fish responded. But when the tortoise was outside water, the fish, no response. So, they analyzed out what is the problem. They called a physicist and analyzed this. They found out that whenever sound changes a medium, that is, changes from the air medium to another medium, especially the water medium, then 99.9% of the sound is reflected away by the medium itself. So, there is a loss of sound in terms of entering the water from air because of a impedance mismatch between the two mediums. Clear? So, because of an impedance mismatch, communication could not happen between the tortoise and the fish. Yeah. We all came out from water and we have become terrestrial, right? To an extent that we have to learn how to swim, otherwise we drown. Okay. So now that we have become terrestrial, the problem of impedance mismatch was there. We were aquatic, we came out. So God is kind. He said, fine. Will gift you something which will bring about a matching of this impedance. And what brings about the matching of the impedance? A transformer. The transformer which is inside your ears is known as the middle ear. Correct? The middle ear was brought in primarily to bring about the impedance matching or to avoid out the impedance mismatch. So here we can very much see we have the external ear, we have the middle ear, the three bones, malleus, incustapes, with the malleus being attached to the tympanic membrane and the stapes being on the round oval window of the cochlea. Clear? Okay. So, how does it work as a transformer? That's what we are understanding. Clear? The basic definition, transformer action of the middle ear is what? It's a hydraulic effect of the tympanic membrane and liver action of the ossicles which combine together to compensate the sound energy lost during transmission from air to liquid medium. Where is air? This is air. Where is liquid? In the ocean. No, cochlea has liquid. It's a liquid medium, no? Pendulum, pendulum, right? So, when sound has to transmit itself from the air medium to the liquid medium, it needs to be matched out for the impedance. Otherwise, a major portion of the sound would be lost, as I explained out. So, the tortoise says, but the water reflects out more than 99% of the sound. Okay? So, the sound which is coming from the air, external ear is filled with what? External ear is filled with what? Air. No. Middle ear is filled with what? Air. Inner ear is filled with what? Fluid. So sound has to go from air medium to fluid medium. There has to be a matching which is done. Otherwise, we cannot hear substantial amount of intensities of sound. Clear? So to do this impedance matching, we have the middle ear. The middle ear does this impedance matching based upon three primary mechanisms. The first mechanism is a curved membrane. Yes. It collects out sounds. And the tympanic membrane is also curved. Here, the yellow portion. And you can see the yellow portion which is curved. Correct? So it collects out the curved membrane. That's the first mechanism by which some amount of sound is retained out or collected. Second mechanism is the liver action. You heard of somebody known as Galileo? He said the earth is round. Fine. He said the earth is round quite much earlier. What is the Hindi word for earth? It is bhugol. Bhu means round and gol means round. He knew it. Anyways, now we say Galileo did. Galileo did something extraordinary. He said that if you give me a long piece of handle in a place outside earth, that is in space, along with a fulcrum, let us say, or a small stone, I can actually lift the earth. Correct? So the second principle based upon which middle ear conserves out a considerable amount of sound is the liver action. Clear? So this is the second mechanism. First mechanism is curved membrane. Second mechanism is the liver action of the middle ear by the combination of the ossicles or the bones. The third is the aerial ratio. Means the ratio of the surface areas. For example, we take an example. This is flying off, right? This needs to be fixed out. Okay? Come, fix it up. Come quick. So we have two options here in front of us. These two are board pins. One of the board pins has the plastic end attached. The other board pin doesn't have the plastic end attached. So we'll ask Maria to fix it. Right. Try out with this. It looks like. If it pains, don't do that. Okay, done. This one. Did you find any difference? Yes, no? What happened? Which was easier? The other one was easier. Sit down. And that is the wonder of the aerial ratio. The moment you have a sharper end this side and a much more area covering end this side, the amount of pressure required out here would be lesser. Did you get hurt? No, no. You got hurt also a little. But you understand how the aerial ratio now for sure. She understands it the best, right? So, this is the aerial ratio. So, that's why you have the nails which have a broader area. You hit it out, it goes in and the sharper end in this side. Tympanic membrane is 85 millimeter square. The effective area of the tympanic membrane is 56.7 millimeter square. Effective area because we have a Schopenhauer's membrane now which doesn't vibrate out also. We have a tight ones and we have a loose ones, right? The loose ones is known as the Schopenhauer's membrane. Okay? So the effective area is 56.7 millimeter square. If you take the area of the oval window, that is the red color one, which is shown quite big, but actually if you take the stapedial foot plate and the red color area, which is the oval window, then the area of the oval window would be 3.2 millimeter square. So if you see, the tympanic membrane is bigger, much bigger than the oval window. And if you put down the ratio comes to be 17.1. Correct. So, do you see the difference in area? In one sense, tympanic membrane is 17 times bigger than the oval window. Is it clear? basic equation, pressure is equal to force per unit area. The same pressure is being transmitted out there in the stapedial footplate. The same pressure on sound creates a pressure, you know that, right? SPL, sound pressure level. The same pressure on the tympanic membrane is transmitted to the stapedial footplate. If it is the same pressure which is being transmitted from a larger area to a smaller area, the way it was done on the boat pin, then the smaller area would be having multiple amount of force as compared to the larger area. Is this clear? Curved membrane buckling effect. The membrane is curved, very much curved, and it buckles out to the bone, the malleus here, and they elastically buckle out to each other, suspended with some tendons, 4 in number, and muscles, 2 in number. So this entire thing is elastically buckled out to each other. So the buckling effect and the curved membrane, they give an advantage of collecting the sound, sending it inward much effectively. Right? This is the second effect which is available. The third effect, because of which there is quite a bit of boost of the sound which is coming in, is known as the liver action. Long piece of handle, one small stone, he puts the stone under the handle, handle under earth, makes it long, pushes out there, and the earth shifts up. Okay, by basic principles of physics, it's very much possible. That's what happens in the middle ear. We have the, let's say, you can see here, if you see, this is the way the tympanic membrane is buckled out to the first bone known as the malleus, second known as the incus, and third known as the stapes. Okay? So here the malleus, the incus, and the stapes are buckled to each other. The fulcrum or the point of movement would be the malleolo-incudal joint, or the joint between the malleus and the incus. That is the point where the movement is. And the ratio of the length are the handle of the malleus and the incus, the long process of the incus. So these are the two ratios. This is the fulcrum. So if you see a diagram here, tympanic membrane, first length of the manubrium of the malleus, fulcrum, the joint between the malleus and the incus, the second length is the length of the long process of the incus, and the moment sound comes in, it combines together to act like a liver. It combines together to act like a liver. This is the joint of the malleus and incus. This is the manubrium of the malleus. This is the long process of the incus. And the moment you press it out, quite a bit of pressure gets translated inside. The combined action of all these three together compensates to the impedance loss which is happening. The total amount of loss which is compensated is 33 decibels. The combined action of the aerial ratio, the curved membrane and the buckling effect, and the liver action. Okay, liver action again, 56.7 millimeter square is the effective area. This is the manubrium of the malleus. This point is the fulcrum or the joint between the malleus and incus. This length is the length of the long process of the incus. The ratio is 1.3:1, and this is the oval window which has an area of 3.2 millimeter square, and this is the stapes piece. The entire combination acts out like a liver, providing out a boost. Three mechanisms adding up together to form the transformer action. That's why we being terrestrial people also can hear each other comfortably. Yeah, middle ear transformer action.